Do you have a little veggie patch in your backyard? Perhaps grow some tomatoes or chilies? Did you know that they may be poisoning you? Soil pollution is on the rise and it may have reached your backyard already. Until recently, we swept it under the ignorance rug. These days, we have solutions though, and they may seem a little unexpected. Welcome to the genetic basis of stuff and things. The first and most important step in curbing climate change is electrifying the grid. This means we want to replace every engine, every boiler, and every stove with an electric version. Sounds easy enough, right? Wrong. Why? Batteries. They use so much metal that the total demand for metals involved in transition technology is projected to increase between 2 to 4 times by 2040. We need to mine a lot of metal. There is a catch though, pollution. Heavy metals are non-degradable. This means that unless interfered, their concentration will only increase with time, whether that is in soil or inside a body. Through metal-based industries, unspeakable amounts of heavy metals are making their way into groundwater reserves and eventually into our food chains. Among others, cadmium and lead, both metals involved in production of batteries, are carcinogenic in humans to different extents. Surely the mining industry is doing something about this, right? Our current solutions for soil pollution include covering it up with clean soil, digging up the polluted soil and displacing it, or when it's really bad, putting it in a big textile bag. We need solutions, fast. And prevention is out of the question. Enter phytoremediation, the use of plants to help curb pollution. There are 3 key aspects of phytoremediation of heavy metals: dissolving the metal, absorbing the ions via the roots, and resistance against the toxic effects of these metals. We've long known that some invasive species have been able to survive and thrive in heavily contaminated soil by regulating the amount of metal they absorb or where it goes once in the plant. We also know about the power of some bacteria and fungi in remediating soil by taking up heavy metals from the soil and managing to not die via complex biochemical pathways. In fact, this is the key aspect of the remediation process. If we can have an organism that acts as a storage container for the heavy metals, not only will we get them out of the soil and subsequently out of our food chains, but we can then collect and extract the metals for industry applications. That's what got us in this mess in the first place, remember? Song and others at Foshan University managed to take advantage of this funky superpower in 2003. They were fascinated by a specific Saccharomyces cerevisiae protein, which detoxifies cadmium and lead and transports it into the vacuoles for storage, and decided to test it on plants using the model organism Arabidopsis thaliana. It worked surprisingly well. Yeast cadmium factor 1 is a common fungal gene in the ATP binding cassette transporter family. Encoded ABCs are membrane proteins that include importers, exporters, and transporters. YCF1 specifically is a vacuole transporter. This gene is heavily associated with multi-drug resistance as well as heavy metal tolerance. When the encoded protein is active, it encapsulates glutathione molecules bound to metals and transports them into the vacuole for storage. This is effective in detoxification as vacuoles are low metabolic activity organelles. During their research, Song et al. Also showed that the deletion of this gene corresponds with reduced resistance to lead and cadmium, and overexpression correlates with increased resistance. Using an agrobacterium plasmid, the researchers inserted YCF1 into 5 lines of plants. All lines showed significant lead and cadmium resistance, and all lines contained significant metal to biomass ratio. This means that not only did they grow in these hostile conditions, but they were also actively sucking lead and cadmium out of the soil and storing it in their vacuoles. This is crucial to effective phytoremediation, and we have it. We have the technology here 21 years ago. Well, nearly. Out of the 3 key principles of effective phytoremediation, this research only covers the 3rd. Plants' ability to convert elemental heavy metals into ions, as well as optimization of the root uptake, is still a heavily researched space. Besides, the longest stale cress roots barely reach 30 centimetres. This is negligible considering tens of metres of contamination in most areas. Song went on to devote his entire career to the study of heavy metal resistant plants, ranging from YCF1 poplar trees to arsenic-resistant rice in 2023. After a push from academics and emergence of countless startups, phytoremediation is being slowly field tested in Australia and overseas using trees and grasses with promising results. We can heal nature with nature, perhaps by giving it a little extra boost of fungal superpowers. Genetically modified organisms aren't something to fear and aren't something to prohibit. While they must continue to be thoroughly researched, in the case of cleaning the planet, GMO is a no-brainer. They will pave the path to a better future.